For over 3,000 years, Egypt was ruled by pharaohs. But in that vast sweep of time, one pharaoh stands out. He would reign for 67 years, command the largest empire on earth, and capture the imagination of the world. His name was Ramesses. Ramesses built a reputation that has resounded through history. It was a reputation deliberately crafted by the pharaoh himself. Ramesses was in fact a master of propaganda, projecting his power beyond the battlefield, across the ancient world. This is the story of how one man created his own legend. The legend of Ramesses the Great. And how in the end, not even a legendary pharaoh could save Egypt's golden empire from destruction. In 1327 BC, a tragic event brought Egypt to the verge of crisis. The pharaoh Tutankhamun had died. His death marked the end of Egypt's most powerful dynasty and the beginning of a period of great uncertainty. A great deal was at stake. In just two centuries, Egypt's royal family had built a massive empire stretching far beyond the Nile. From Syria in the north to the gold fields of Nubia, modern-day Sudan, in the south. A succession of powerful pharaohs had made Egypt the richest and most powerful nation in the world.
When Tutankhamun died, the big problem was that there was no heir to the throne. So obviously Egypt must have been in a bad state. There was nobody there to take over, and things were in a state of flux.
But now, with the end of the great dynasty, a new enemy had emerged to challenge Egypt's might, the Hittites. The Hittites, living in what is now Turkey, were a more technologically advanced power than Egypt. Already they were pushing against the northern border of Egypt's empire. In 1279 BC, the fate of the threatened empire became the responsibility of a young boy, the new pharaoh of Egypt. He was crowned Ramesses, meaning offspring of the sun god Ra.
Ramesses comes to the throne fairly young, probably about the age of 15. And he's got an enormous task ahead of him. He looks back over the history of his country. 100 years or so earlier, there were kings who were the epitome of wealth, power, and good taste. That's an enormous legacy to have to live up to.
Ramesses had not come from a royal background. In fact, the boy king had been born a commoner.
Ramesses' family was a military family who were fairly new on the throne. They were certainly not from the royal line. They were near the royal line. They lived and worked for the kings of Egypt, but they did not belong to the royal family.
It was military prowess that had won Ramesses' family its place on the throne. And it would be through military action that the young Ramesses would have to prove himself.